Hi everyone, it's Rachel back with the Shades of Orange. Today I want to recommend some horror that is perfect for the summer months. I hear a lot of people talk about reading seasonally, and typically people talk about craving horror in the fall and winter months, but if you follow my channel, you know that I read horror all year long, and I actually think there are a lot of good horror books that are really good to read in the summer when it's hot, and I basically want to recommend some to you to hopefully inspire you to keep reading it even though it is hot and beautiful outside. This is a perfect time to pick up something creepy as your next beach read. All that being said, let's get into the books. Now first I want to recommend some horror short stories, and for that I want to go with Ghost Summer by Tiana Reeve Dew. This collection is centered around a small town in Florida, and I really like the first couple stories in the collection, one being The Lake, which is about a teacher who moves to the small town and enlists the help of some teenage boys to renovate the house surrounding the lake on her property. It's creepy for a couple different reasons and has some great imagery. I really can't say more than that. I also loved a story called Summer, which is about a mother taking care of her fussy child, which I connected with quite a bit as a parent myself. I should mention that not all the stories in this collection are centered around summer, but the first couple are. And I think if you're looking for that hot, sticky atmosphere, especially you'll find in the southern area of Florida, you will definitely get that from these stories. So I highly recommend the stories centered around summer in this collection. Now for something a little longer, I want to recommend a novella, and that is The Turtle Boy by Keelan Patrick Burke. This is about a young boy and his best friend that are off for the summer. They are away from school and are just enjoying the fact that they can do what they want, hang out, and have a good time, and of course get in trouble. So they decide to go to a lake that their parents have told them to stay away from, and when they are there, they find this mysterious creepy boy that they call the Turtle Boy. And this boy is standing in the water and tells them that he's feeding the turtles. And they're just weirded out, and from there the story goes, and I don't want to give away too much because it is a shorter narrative, but I think this will appeal to other people who remember their own childhood very nostalgically. The ability to have time off, to have that freedom to do what you want and run around with your friends. And this story definitely packs an emotional punch, so if that sounds up your alley, I definitely recommend it. Next, if I'm going to talk summer horror, I have to recommend one of my favorites, and that of course is Kill River by Cameron Rubik. This is about a young girl named Cindy whose parents send her off to summer camp. She doesn't really want to go, but when she's there she does make some friends, and they decide to sneak off from the camp and go to an abandoned water park. Of course, this water park is not as empty as they think it is, and they realize soon enough that a killer is in the park with them and is slowly going to kill them off one by one. You know that I love a good slasher story, and this one is a lot of fun. It is set in the 80s, and so it has a lot of that retro feel, and I think will definitely appeal to people who were perhaps kids during the 80s themselves, but regardless of your age, I think this one is a lot of fun, and I just had a blast reading it. I think it would be great to pick up if you're going to a water park yourself or just laying on the beach, and you know I enjoyed this one. I've recommended it before, and that's for good reason. I really enjoyed it. And for another slasher, I want to recommend The Summer Is Ended and We Are Not Yet Saved by Joey Kamo. And this is about a young boy whose mother sends him to a Bible camp over the summer so that she can work as a makeup artist on a horror movie set. And when he is there, something is wrong with the camp and kids are slowly dying off. And he has to figure out what's happening and how to get out of the camp. And the story is so much fun. I loved the aspect of the mother being a makeup artist. I think anyone who's interested in horror movie film will really enjoy those parts of the story because she writes letters to her son. And then of course there's a main attraction at the camp. And I do have to mention that unlike a lot of other slashers, the people in this camp are more children than teenagers. So if you are uncomfortable with harm to younger children, this one does have some more difficult moments in it, but I really enjoyed it. It's a very self-aware horror story, and I think it's just very smart and funny, and if that sounds like the kind of thing you enjoy, I highly recommend it. It's probably one of my favorite slasher books I've ever read, so I cannot recommend that one enough. So finally, I want to recommend Camp Carnage by Joshua Winning and Elliot Arthur Cross. This is a slasher story centered around a camp where parents send their children that identify as either gay or lesbian in order for this Bible camp to try to convert them to be heterosexual. And the story basically makes fun of these terrible pray away the gay camps. And instead, the boys and girls really enjoy the fact that they are in a camp with a bunch of other people who identify the same way. And so a lot of relationships, crushes, and hookups ensue. And at the same time, this is a horror story. So there is a killer on the loose who is slashing down these young individuals. And it's just a lot of fun. The representation in this book is very spot on. I love the character development. You get to really know these people as well-rounded individuals. And at the end of the day, it's a fun camp story involving boys and girls at summer camp, which is just something that I really enjoy reading. So those are five horror books that I would recommend reading in the summer. It's by no means an exhaustive list, so I'd love to get your own recommendations down below. What horror books do you think are perfect to read when it's hot and sunny outside? As well, what are you planning on reading this summer in terms of horror? If you haven't already, I do encourage you to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoy these kind of creepy videos. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I will talk to you again soon. Okay, bye-bye.